the late 1940s, man-made substances known as PFASs have been used to repel oil, grease, soil, and water in countless consumer products, ranging from cookware to carpets. Because these chemicals don't break down naturally, they are now found in the environment pretty much wherever scientists look for them. PFASs are sometimes called forever chemicals because they are so persistent. Many are also harmful to people or wildlife. Some can cause cancer or harm the immune system.
We at the Safer Consumer Products Program at the California Department of Toxic Substances Control, or DTSC, are working with public and private stakeholders to find safer alternatives to PFASs. We're focusing on PFASs in carpets and rugs, food packaging, and textile treatments, and could expand that list in the future.
But regulating PFASs is a major challenge. They are a large, diverse group of more than 5,000 chemicals with diverse chemical structures. Targeting them individually is next to impossible.
If you regulate just one PFAS at a time, manufacturers could replace it with another PFAS that could turn out to be just as hazardous or sometimes even worse. We call that regrettable substitution.
Here's an example. Since the voluntary phase-out of the longer-chain PFASs in some parts of the world, manufacturers have shifted to PFASs with 6 or fewer carbons, such as perfluorohexanoic acid or PFHXA. While these shorter-chain PFASs have not been studied as much as the longer-chain PFASs they replace, some of them have also been documented to be hazardous to humans or the environment.
One of the best ways to avoid regrettable substitutions is to regulate PFASs as a class. DTSC is one of the first regulatory bodies to do that, and it's possible because of our unique regulatory framework. We use a hazard-based approach, rather one that is risk-based. To regulate a consumer product, we need only find evidence that it may potentially expose people or the environment to a so-called candidate chemical, and that this exposure has the potential to cause or contribute to harm.
Most PFASs have not been evaluated for safety. What is known is that all members of the class are either extremely persistent in the environment or break down to other PFASs that are. Environmental persistence is the most widely recognized hazard trait of the PFAS class. The reason PFASs don't break down in the environment is the very strong chemical bond between carbon and fluorine atoms shared by all members of the class.
Because PFASs stay in the environment for a long time, we know that once they are released, they continue to expose plants, animals, and people over time. These exposures may continue to cause harm long after the PFASs were originally used. In this way, PFASs are similar to legacy chemicals like DDT and PCBs, which have remained public health concerns decades after their production and use were banned.
By regulating PFASs as a class rather than one at a time, California's Safer Consumer Products Program is taking a precautionary approach to protect vulnerable human and environmental populations and habitats. Our paper detailing our approach to regulating PFASs as a class was just published in the journal Environmental Health Perspectives. We hope our paper can be helpful to other regulatory agencies who seek to comprehensively address this large class of chemicals.